Models in Laravel. Why do you need them? How do you use them? What is ORM? In this video, I'll answer these questions. When building an application, you'll usually need to interact with a database. To retrieve specific data, you use queries, but this approach has some issues. Take this simple SQL query as an example for selecting a user by email. You have to be cautious about SQL injection by using parameterized queries or sanitizing inputs. Another issue is the repetitive nature of writing queries like this repeatedly. If you just want to select one user, you have to write out select from every time. For these reasons and more, ORM, Object Relational Mapping, was created. ORM acts as a bridge between your application and the relational database. Instead of writing SQL queries directly, you use objects and methods from your programming language to interact with the database. The ORM then translates these operations into SQL, allowing you to work with data in an object-oriented way without manually writing SQL. In Laravel, the ORM is called Eloquent. Eloquent provides an intuitive, active record-based approach to database interaction, where each database table is represented by a model in your application. Models let you work with table rows as if they were objects, with methods for creating, reading, updating, and deleting records. Common operations are much simpler, and Eloquent helps protect against SQL injection by default. To create a model in Laravel, use the command php artisan make model model name. The model name should be singular, like user instead of users. Once the model is created, you can define properties and relationships in it. Each model corresponds to a specific table. By default, Eloquent assumes the table name is the plural form of your model name, so for a user model, it would look for a user's table. If the table doesn't match this convention, you can specify it in the model using the protected table property. You can also create a model with the M parameter, like PHP artisan make model model name, which generates both the model and a migration. This automatically sets the table name as expected by Eloquent. In your model, you can customize several options. For example, by default, Eloquent assumes your table has a primary key column named ID. If your table uses a different primary key, you can specify it using the protected primary key property. If you want to use a non-incrementing or non-numeric primary key, set the public incrementing property to false and specify the type with the protected key type property. Eloquent also expects created at and updated at columns by default. You can disable this behavior by setting the public timestamps property to false. There are additional customizable attributes, but I won't cover all of them here. Single results are returned as a model instance, while queries that return multiple results are returned as Eloquent collections. These collections can be easily converted to a PHP array using toArray. Let's look at a few examples. To get all articles, you can use the all method. To retrieve a model by primary key, you can use find, for example, to get the article with an ID of 1. You can also build more advanced queries. For example, to get the last 3 published articles, the query might look like this. First, you apply a where condition. The first parameter is the column name, and the second is the value you want to match. You can also use operators like inequality, with the value being the third parameter. Then use order by to sort in descending order and take to limit the results. This is the query builder, so you can always chain more methods. It doesn't need to be written in a single line. Results are returned when you use the get method. As you can see, the method names are similar to SQL, but there's more to it. What about relationships? For instance, if you want to get the first article and then its author, the user model, you can define relationships inside your models. Let's look at an example. In the article model, I've created a user method with a belongsTo relationship to the user model. This allows me to easily retrieve the user associated with an article. Similarly, in the user model, I can define an articles method with a hasMany relationship to retrieve all articles written by that user. There are several types of relationships in Eloquent, but the most common are: one-to-one hasOne, one-to-many is many, inverse one-to-many belongs to, By default, Eloquent determines foreign key names by adding suffixes like underscore ID to the method name or based on the parent method name, depending on the relationship. However, you can specify custom foreign and local keys as the second and third parameters if your naming convention differs. You can also chain multiple relationships. For example, from an article, you can retrieve the author, the user model, then from that user, you can get related data like user roles. This is much simpler than writing SQL queries with joins. Now that you know the basics of selecting data, let's look at how you can use Eloquent to create new rows or update existing ones. Let's create a new article. To do this, you can use the create method and pass the data as an array. The result will be the created model, so you can easily retrieve the ID of the last created record, which is often needed. There's one important concept to explain here, as it can cause issues for beginners. To pass data to the create method, you need to set either the fillable or guarded property in your model. This property should be an array that defines which columns can be mass assigned with fillable or which ones should be excluded from mass assignment with guarded. Which one you use is up to you. Fillable works like a whitelist and guarded works like a blacklist. Why is this necessary? It provides automatic protection against mass assignment vulnerabilities. When validating data, you typically define rules for specific fields. The important part is how you handle the data from the request. Some developers use the all method on the request object to get all the data, though there are other approaches as well. There is one security issue to consider. What if there's a field you didn't validate because you didn't expect it to be sent? For example, it could be the ID column or created at. If you pass data from the request directly to the create method, it could inadvertently modify columns that shouldn't be modified by the user. This is not safe. That's why the fillable or guarded properties are essential. You should blacklist columns that shouldn't be modified or whitelist those that are allowed to be. By default, columns like ID, created at, and updated at should typically be blacklisted, but it may depend on your table's structure. For updating data, there are at least two common approaches. You can filter the data using where and then use update for the modified columns. Alternatively, if you want to modify specific columns in an existing model, you can set the properties directly and then use save. To delete a model, simply call the delete method on the model instance. This is a broad topic, so there's not enough time to cover everything in detail here. However, I'll create additional videos on advanced model usage and query building. There are two more questions to address. What are the disadvantages of using Eloquent, and are there situations when you should use raw SQL? The biggest drawback of using Eloquent models is performance, especially if they're used incorrectly. Since queries are generated automatically, there may be cases where the auto-generated query is less efficient than a manually crafted raw SQL query. It all depends on your specific use case, but in general, I'd say Eloquent models should always be used for simpler tasks like basic CRUD operations. They make things easier and should not cause significant performance issues. However, if you have a very complex query with subqueries, aggregating large datasets, or other performance-critical operations, you might want to consider using raw SQL. That being said, Eloquent models are great, but raw SQL can be a useful tool for certain situations too. Finally, let's take a look at what I believe to be the most common use cases for Eloquent models.